Lock one.
It's funny here, Guy McCrean now, Agarwal with you here. I'm just listening around here, the sounds, you commentating the previous match, all these lovely young voices around, the African vibrancy, the culture, everything around here, that this sport is back in Africa, the World Championships. You're getting that feeling that we're watching the table tennis, but the significance of the occasion.
Oh, yeah, of course. Having the World Championships on African soil is just absolutely historic. You can already see folks lined up this wonderful hall, wanting to see the best table tennis on planet Earth in front of their eyes. And what better to see Lian Jingkun, world number five.
One.
Yeah, he's made a razor sharp start, drops his first point there. Catching the edge, but three of the first 4 points. For all of us, I mean, for those maybe watching for the first time, for us who've watched Liang many times, doesn't get boring.
One.
It's not dull watching this level. It's the challenge that's facing De La Peña here. This 23-year-old, just outside the world's top 100.
Two.
There was a little touch there, actually. So he's got the point back. I think a touch of the shirt. Through there. Point awarded. And that's nice there.
Oh.
The length. The trick.
Yeah, nice serve. It seemed like the shot came out a bit. But, well, no. It's really hard to surprise the Chinese, right? Kudos to De La Peña for producing that sort of a serve.
Three, four.
Well, first 3 points his way, but De La Peña taking the next four here.
Five, three.
Committed everything to that, really, in position to come back.
Net 5-4.
Beautiful backhand that from De La Peña, came out of nowhere.
You know, it's as you said, Neha, you can go around this, you know, your own experience. You're playing a much, you know, you're not expected to do anything here. He's come out pretty loose, even when he lost the first 3 points.
Five, six.
Yeah, he's going all out. He has no fear in his mind. And I love that, you know, you should not give too much respect to your opponent. Well, you're playing against world number five, the best Chinese, probably.
Six.
But you try to do whatever you can and go all out. I watched Lian Jingkun won the WTT Star Contender in Goa few weeks back, and he was so strong against Lin Shindong in the finals. Just waiting to see him roar like he usually does.
Six, oh.
He's a very animated, can be a very animated character, Liang. It was actually quite a run that he had there. You mentioned the event that you commentated, because it wasn't just Lin Shindong in the finals. It was actually quite a tough draw, wasn't it? Because he had Lin Gaoyuan, his compatriot, in the quarters, and then he had Tomokazu Harimoto in the semis.
Seven.
I mean, it's a trio of wins. That wasn't easy to win that event for him. He's just trying to reassert himself here. Point in front. He's just so, Neha, we can get thoughts as goes on here. Liang, always the thing to me is he's so busy as well, active in everything he does. I mean, that point's a good example. He's just there, buzzing. the whole time.
Yeah, and top players have to do that because you stay in the game, you're always engaged, and you're ready for long rallies. It's in the game of TT, it's very important to always stay low as well, so that you're closer to the table, you're ready for the balls.
Nine.
Brilliant serve with a lot of backspin in that.
Here's the run which has seen him reassert his authority in this opening game. Liang Jingkun was behind, remember, by a point or so. But now has three chances to close it out.
Brilliant from Della Pena to hang in there. 8-10 in this first game.
Yeah, one game point save, but Liang now back with the service here. Two more to come. I think we'll close it out here.
Wow,
brilliant serve from Liang Jingkun.
We'll also begin the second.
Lock one.
Liang Jingkun ranked 103 in the world. Also, the highest New Zealander, highest ranked New Zealander on planet Earth in the game of table tennis. Should be proud of himself for that.
Well, he's got an interesting story, Neha, because, you know, he's not coming from in China or an established nation in that sense, and then you get all these interesting stories about how, what your thoughts on that, how players first of all get to know the game, get an opportunity. I mean, in his case, it's a club in West Auckland, but even before that, that's where he's coaching now and playing. But yeah, introduced when he was watching his dad, just went along and watched his dad play in an event, and that got him hooked, simple as that.
Yeah, and he's so young. He's playing and coaching at the same time, trying to spread the game of table tennis in New Zealand. Not too many players from New Zealand on the tour, so I'm sure Della Pena is so proud of himself to be putting up a good fight against Liang Jingkun so far. The last game was spectacular from his side.
There again,
also because he's a left-hander, he's getting better angles, and I always love to see left-handers versus righties. One is, we have very, you generally have few left-handers, right, on the tour, so the angles that they can produce versus the right-handers is too wide, so gotta try to take that advantage to your side.
Ooh, run of points here for Della Pena. Good body language about him as well.
And he's leading 4-3 now.
Three, five.
Superb down the line attack from Della Pena. He's just trying to make as many variations as possible in the game, changing the flanks really well.
4-5.
Like I mentioned before, table tennis is a game of serve and attack, right? And Liang Jingkun is so dominant in his serves. You saw the last one where he closed out the match. The serve was so short, the ball didn't get out of the table, it just stayed. So many variations he's got in his fold.
Mid 6-4.
Oh,
seven,
again, classy.
Four.
He's playing very nicely here, really uninhibited. Look at that run on the world number five.
Five,
a million
seven.
Miles away from making that. I mean, what he's doing is they're going to the tail break now is, I mean, you talked about Liang and what he does. What we say with the top players, the very best of which he's won, they don't actually want to get involved in these longer rallies. They want to keep the points as short as possible. But De La Peña is doing a good job at the moment of extending rallies, and then we see what he can do.
Yeah, it's really, really hard to match the speed and spins of top players, and thus really hard to get into long rallies against that. So kudos to De La Peña, the Kiwi, producing his best table tennis.
Lit. Six, seven.
Yes, as you say, I mean, it's a serve receive and then the plus one basically after that, and the top players are so good at it. Avoiding longer rallies and coming out on top of those short points. Liang is another one who does that invariably, but it hasn't, well, he's not dominated here so far.
Eight, six.
No mercy at all. It was actually a good change of serve from De La Peña.
Made to not look like it.
Yeah, but it seems like Liang just read his mind and knew that it's going to be a long one.
Away here from him at the moment. That's 3 points in a row though for Liang.
Eight,
and that could be so intimidating, Guy, because it was a slight backhand spin. Look at the wrist work out there. The ball went so fast and so quick. If I were De La Peña, I would be disappointed at this point.
He hasn't actually done too much wrong here. He's still two game points down. New Zealander.
9-10.
That gutsy serve, I would say. Lot of backspin in there. So much so that, you know, the best in the world does not understand the amount of backspin coming in. Just love so much variation De La Peña has in his game.
Yeah, it's clever receive that. Nine. Changes what's expected, but he is two up still.
Long one.
Yeah, and you set such high standards. It's always so hard to live up to those, right? And tell the world that you're one of the best. So, generally, it could be a lot of pressure as well when you're playing opponents who are way below in world rank against you.
Lit. Lob. One.
But I have to give it to De La Peña's, you know, gutsy play so far. He's so, so confident.
Two. Lob.
I mean, no words from my side, Guy.
No. I mean, you just sit back and admire this, don't you? You don't get bored of that. You can watch that stuff again and again.
All day long.
Because it's, again, you know, we were talking about it off air beforehand. The World Championships is kind of a wider audience. It's a showcase for the sport. We have the best in the sport. We've talked about the regularly, and we will do about the historic nature of this edition because, of course, we're back in Africa. First time in over 80 years. But you have people, I always say this, who just watch, hey, just tune in for the World Championships. And they go, wow, he's able to do that, you know, and just do it so regularly. They make it look easy. That's the thing. I mean, it's not to consistently execute like that. But they make it so.
Yeah, the best players in the world, right? You see Roger Federer in tennis. The way he makes those backhand it's like so flawless, so easy. And similarly, are these top players like Lian Jingkun, the backhand that he made in the previous shot was so effortless. But trust me, it takes years and years of hard work and thousands of hours to be able to make that backhand.
Five, one.
Such a decent service, but a really good push. Really feathered that, Lian. The receive there. Again, it's the placement. He's so smart. Varied. Yeah. Controlling points behind his serve. He's improved in that regard. Still not where he'd like the numbers to be, Lian, but going in the right direction.
6-1.
That was like a slap from Lian Jingkun. Turns around and boom. One, he's really now getting seven. Into his element. You can see the scores. 7-1 for the Chinese.
Yeah. It's a mixture of things here, I think, in this game. He's starting to go up a gear, and also, I think, got to say, De La Peña played great in those first couple of games.
Eight.
And the problem is, it's just he's got to, naturally, he's got to be at that level to stand a chance. If he drops ever so slightly, well, this is what happens, what we're seeing in this third. Yeah, he's just starting to stamp his authority on this, really, increasingly so, Lian. 2 points from a three-gamer.
Lightning speed from Lian Jingkun, and that's what he actually plays all day long. I was waiting for him to show us all of this.
9 game points.
Oof.
Oh,
two,
hello.
Ten.
I'm still there.
Yeah, I was about to say. Well, there's one for the real. Might not make much of a difference to this third game, but that is a moment to savor. It's like, you did that, Liang. He is still here, but maybe for not much longer in this third game, De La Peña. 8 more game points. Oh, touch play and the follow-up. Ah, it's naughty. Who knows, this could be Liang Jingkun's year. Been a bronze medalist twice. I think actually on that, Neho, get your thoughts on that with Liang. He's shown, I mean, you talked about his results. He's been a bronze medalist twice. His problem coming in here, though, is that he's maybe a little bit more vulnerable to non-compatriots, he's shown, than some of the other Chinese players, and that could maybe be his issue. Has been beaten coming in.
Also, if you can see the much more favored, like Ma Long and Feng Jindong, whom at least the table tennis fans have been waiting to add another crown in their kitty, right? So where do folks like Lian Jingkun, who are making their way, fit in?
Three,
so it would be lovely to see where we, as we progress through in the tournament, can he make a few upsets and go up into the ladder? But well, now I want to bring all of us back to De La Peña. I would say just so proud of the effort that he's putting in so far at the World Championships here against world number 5. I tell you, it could be so intimidating to play in your first round at the World Championship against one of the top players in the world.
And we've got a timeout here with the game and the match going away from De La Peña, rather.
Make sure the first two balls are done right and then stay in the rally. But that's tricky, right? I mean, at that level, the sort of variations and the speed at which the top Chinese play is so magnanimous that it's hard to just match it, even if you have, very high fitness levels. But TT is so fast. It's just hard to match if you're not at that level.
Six.
Yeah, I think it's a great point you make. There is always there that It's sort of saying he has to stay in the point a little bit more, but actually where he troubled him in the first couple of games in particular, he was taking the attack to Liang, and he's maybe just, on his coach's advice, just backing off a bit, and that's not going to be the way to take points, you feel. Just kind of plays into Liang's hands as the much more storied player, better player.
Yeah, and top players also read the game of the opponents really well. They understand the weaknesses really well. So Liang took the first two games to probably understand that, but the next two has been just totally one-sided.
2-8.
Nice change in spin from Della Pena. A very loopy forehand spin.
Seen that a few times. And again, we don't get bored of it. That point construction, easy does it for Liang. Opens up the table. I've actually been impressed with him here, but in the end, as you might expect, Liang is just a class apart in the matchup. 7 match points here. And just 11, the one needed. 3, that will do for Liang Jingkun, the bronze medalist from the last 2 World Championships in singles.